गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. टुडे वी विल लर्न द जूम असाइनमेंट की ऑफ क्लास 9th डेटेड 19th. सो नारायण लाइव क्लासेस की डिस्कशन ऑन डेट 19th ऑफ क्लास 9th. क्लास 9th डेटेड 19th. ओके, व्हाट इज द टॉपिक? चेंजिंग कल्चरल ट्रेडिशंस इन यूरोप 1300 टू 1800 AD. व्हाट डिड वी लर्न यस्टरडे? वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द डिफरेंट अचीवमेंट्स. And today we are going to learn about the masterpieces of the trio in the art. Who are the trio in the art? That is Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo and Raphael. These three are known as the trio in the art. So, first question is that one. That is, what was the masterpiece of Da Vinci? Everybody knows Mona Lisa. But apart from Mona Lisa, one more picture is that, that is the Last Supper. The Last Supper was the wonderful contribution of our Da Vinci, where Jesus Christ will be sharing all the supper along with all his followers. That is really wonderful painting, children. So the first question is based upon that. That is, who was the artist who was endowed with this Last Supper? That is Leonardo da Vinci. Option B is the right answer. And now the next, that is, apart from Leonardo da Vinci, there were also some other very famous personalities. Some other famous personalities regarding the art and architecture. So, that at that particular time, so many people, they have revived different cultures of ancient period. Especially the Roman Colosseum, Roman Colosseum is even fascinating today. So, such kind of famous buildings, they were seen and they have adopted that kind of paintings nowadays. That is called as a classical type of painting. So, the imperial Roman constructions which they wanted to revive once again, they were called as the classical. They were called as the classical style or imperial style. Okay, and you know very well that Filippo Brunelleschi, very very famous personality who has painted that Duomo of Florence. Duomo of the Florence, that is the option C of the third question. So, who is that associated with the Brunelleschi? Brunelleschi was associated with the Duomo of the Florence. Okay, and at the same time we have that one more very very important thing, that is, during this particular period, the Europeans, they were endowed with the highest knowledge of the printing also. Actually, Europeans were not the inventors of the printing press. The printing, the ancient printing knowledge goes to the Chinese. The credit goes to Chinese, because the Chinese and the Japanese, they have used the blocks and with the help of the blocks, they started the printing technology. So, the Europeans shall be indebted to whom? To the Chinese. That is the next question. That is, the Europeans shall be indebted to whom? They shall be indebted to the Chinese for the knowledge of this printing press. And the next one is, with the help of the printing press, first book to be printed was the Bible. How many copies were printed? 150 copies of Bible were printed. 150 copies of the Bible were printed, and that was option A. And at the same time, do you know who was the first person to start the printing press in Europe, that is in Germany? He is none other than the Johannes Gutenberg. That is Gutenberg, option B. Option B. So, these are the, that means Da Vinci was the artist who painted the Last Supper. And Last Supper was painted by this Leonardo Da Vinci. The Imperial Roman Colosseum, or such kind of revival of the Roman culture, is called as the imperialistic style. And that is Brunelleschi, he painted the Duomo of Florence. And the next one is printing press. For the knowledge of this printing press, the Europeans shall be indebted to the Chinese, because Chinese and Japanese were the first people to print with the blocks. And what was the first book to be printed? Bible. How many copies? 150 copies. And finally, the last one is the printing press. Who started the printing press? Was Johannes Gutenberg. Johannes Gutenberg. Now tell the next question is what was the use of this printing technology? The time that is needed to print was very less. That means within a short span of time, they are able to print so many books. If they have to write a written copy of a Bible, whatever the time that is taken to write one copy, within that time we are able to print almost 1500 to 1600 copies. That means time consumption is very less. And at the same time, the knowledge because of the books printed getting printed very easily, the knowledge also got spread to each and every area because of the books only. That is the reason, children, that you are able to get the knowledge with the help of your books. Read your books perfectly, whether that is textbook or workbook, whatever it may be. You read them, understand them, then automatically your knowledge will be enhanced. So, knowledge enhancement is one more very important aspect of this printing press. And the third one is everything now is very easily available to the common man. Common because now the cost is very less. At the same time, previously the common man, as he is an illiterate, he has to depend on the church officials for everything. He doesn't know what is the what. But now the Bible is printed. If he can get a simple literacy, he can read the Bible and he can get the knowledge. He can know the truth. So everything is available to the common man nowadays. These are the important aspects of this printing press. And the next one is what are the effects of this printing press? What are the effects of this printing press? Effects are very simple because the human culture, humanism has developed, no? This human culture, it started spreading very fastly. Rather than the religion, they started spreading this human culture very fast to each and every corner of the life, and the scientific knowledge, they started sharing among different countries, not only in their country. Whatever the knowledge that they have possessed, they started sharing with the other countries. That's all for today, children. Tomorrow we'll meet with one more theme. Until then, good evening. Thank you.